Hello, my friends. My name is Vadim Olejnik, and right now I will explain and show you the proper form of regular dips and bar dips, because the basic exercises is the key that will open the door into the world of the calisthenics. Let's go. Okay, my friends, so there is two types of different technique of regular dips. The first one you should use for body weight work and also for weighted calisthenics. Okay, so let's go. If your regular dips it's high enough, so you can keep and you're able to keep your body straight, so while you're doing the regular dips you should keep your body straight without any moves, without bending your legs, without bending your lower back, whatever. You should keep your body straight, and the most important thing, try to relax other part of your muscles. Try to concentrate yourself only on the muscle that you should use for the regular dips: chest, triceps and your shoulder. Okay, so let's go. So when you're ready in on a deep position, you can cross your legs if it's more comfortable for you. It's not a problem. And you cannot, like, this is the biggest mistakes for most of the people. When they doing the dips and they put their elbows close to the back, like this. This is the biggest mistake. Why? Because if you put your elbows close to your back, you're activating your scapula muscles while you're doing the dips. And you cannot activate your scapula while you're doing the dips. This is the thing, you know? That's why you have to put your elbows to the 45 degrees. In this way, you will activate the muscles that you should use while you're doing the regular dips. Check the correct form. It was the first technique, and remember that you have to go lower than the 90 degree, at least to the 90 degree. But try to not go all the way down like this, because in this way, if your muscles are not prepared for it, you can get injured your shoulders, your elbows. That's why the safest way is to go straight to the 90 degree or a bit lower. Okay, and the second form, it sounds special dips that actually you don't need to do for reps. You have to do them slowly to feel the core, to feel the chest, the shoulders, because this form and this way of doing the dips, the harder one, and that form of the dips will keep your strength to the next level. Okay, you're going up to the deep position, then you push your knees to the chest and hold them in this position like this. After, you open your elbows outside and slowly you're going down all the way down. From that position you push yourself up, whoosh, again all the way down with the elbows outside, whoosh, open your elbows. So this kind of dips will activate your core, your chest, triceps and your shoulders. And this kind of dips, it's not for using, for adding the weights. It's not for increasing the reps. It's just to get the pump and to feel your muscles, to connect your muscle with your mind, okay? So right now we will move to the correct form and proper way of doing the bar dips. Let's go. Okay, my friends, so right now I will show you how to do the bar dips with the proper form and how to avoid the most popular mistakes. The most popular mistake that people has when they are over the bar and when they start doing the bar dips, they put their legs in the front. Their legs automatically goes to the front. Why? Because they try to straight them. They try to keep their core, their legs, you know? And the key of all of it, of all the basic exercises, and maybe in another exercises that you will use in the calisthenics, you have to relax yourself. You have to connect your muscles with your mind. This is the key to get the proper form. When I'm doing the bar dips, I totally relaxing everything that goes lower from my chest. It looks that I'm doing the bar dips in the same line. My legs doesn't move, my upper body also, it doesn't moving at all. When you are already over the bar, you have to put your hands a bit wider than the line of your shoulders, okay? You cannot put your hands closer. In this way, all the pressure of your weight will go straight to your elbows. And this is the problem, because in this way, you can get injured. There is a little secret. When you are already over the bar, you have to make a little centimeter like this with your shoulders, because if you stay like this, you will all the time you will touching the bar with your core, okay? And you have to make a little centimeter, and in this way you're not gonna touch the bar. Also, very important thing, that the point you have to touch the bar while you're doing the bar dips, it's the top of your core. Look, when you put in your hands straight to the 90 degree, the end of your hand, it's the top of your core. So if you're touching the bar with the top of your core, you're doing the proper bar dips. As you can see, while I'm doing the bar dips, my legs doesn't move. Like, I have a total control of my body, of my upper body and my lower body. Also, remember, while you're doing the bar dips, you should keep your elbows outside. If you keep your elbows outside, that means your triceps, your shoulder and your chest working in a proper way, and this exercise will give you really good results. And that's why in all basic exercises that I explained to you before, you will reach the highest progress if you will keep the proper form. Let's go to the different variations on the regular dips. Okay, my friends, so the first variation of regular dips, it's a jumping. In this exercise, you will improve your explosive power and you will get a control of your body, okay? So check it out. Okay, my dear friends, so the next variation of regular dips, I call it walk in the hell. Check it out. Okay, my friends, so it was the second variation of the regular dips, and the third one, it's really challenging one, you know. So for example, you start from the five regular dips at the beginning, then you're walking forward, making the five dips at the end, and then you're walking back, making four, and by stairs, like 4 4 3 3 2 2 1 1, for example. Check it out. Okay, my friends, so it was the third variation of the regular dips, and right now we are moving to the next one, to the style volume dips. Okay, it was the fourth variation. It was the Vadim style dips. I hope that you really like it. And let's move to the next one, to the club regular dips. And right now we are moving to the last different type of regular dips. In this one, the most important thing that you should hold while you're doing it, you go down, like lower to the 90 degree, like regular dip, and from that position, you have to use your explosive power to switch to the one single bar. And you switch already to the push position. Then you push and you switch again to the regular dip. Again, you push, you switch to the bar dip. So this exercise will really improve your explosive power. You will get dynamic. You need to get a coordination, you know? It's very important. It will look easy, but it's really hard, you know? Check it out. So it was the last variation of different type of regular dips, and I really hope, my friends, that you enjoyed this video, that you learn something new for yourself, because I'm putting in my heart and my soul to make this video good. So I'm waiting for your likes, comments under the video. Share this video and subscribe my channel. See you soon.